The James Webb Space Telescope, recently launched collectively by NASA, the European Space Agency, and the Canadian Space Agency, is an incredible piece of technology. According to NASA, its origami-style construction includes a mirror which consists of 18 segments made of ultra-lightweight beryllium. It has a huge sunshield the size of a tennis court, which consists of 5 layers to keep the telescope safe from the intense heat of the sun.
Yes, it's amazing that it's able to do this with nothing more than these layers.
And it's armed with 4 instruments, both cameras and spectrometers, which are super sensitive and can pick up the faintest signals from space. They work in the infrared wavelength, allowing the telescope to peer through clouds of dust, which would obscure its video if it looked in the visible light wavelength. But what is it all for? What do you do with the world's most powerful space telescope? The answer is that you use it for all sorts of research. And it might help us answer some of the biggest questions in astronomy.
There are just an infinite number of questions I want to answer.
One of the most exciting topics in astronomy right now is the search for planets outside of our solar system, which are called exoplanets. It's hard to detect planets because they are so much smaller and less bright than stars. However, by using some clever methods, astronomers have been able to identify over 4,000 of these exoplanets to date. There are likely countless more waiting to be discovered. You'd think at least one of them would prove to be inhabitable.
Well, if there wasn't, it'd be an awful waste of space.
Ultimately, we don't know much about these planets. Typically, you might only be able to tell a planet's approximate size or mass, and its distance from the star it orbits. It's also sometimes possible to determine if a planet is rocky, like Earth or Mars, or a gas giant, like Jupiter or Saturn. But beyond that, these planets remain shrouded in mystery. The next big step in understanding exoplanets, especially if we're hoping to find a second inhabitable planet, is to see if a given exoplanet has an atmosphere. Think about the differences between Earth, which has a rich atmosphere, and Mars, which has a very thin atmosphere. Knowing what the composition of an atmosphere is and how thick it is key to understanding what the environment of an exoplanet would be like. James Webb will be able to detect exoplanet atmospheres using its infrared instruments. By pointing directly at a distant star and remaining stationary, the instruments will be able to detect small changes in brightness when a planet passes between the star and a telescope. These tiny dips can be analyzed to learn more about the distant planet, including whether or not there's an atmosphere of gases around the planet and how thick they are. Another amazing ability James Webb will have is to look back on some of the earliest galaxies, which is like peering back in time. That works because light takes time to travel. So when you look at something incredibly distant, it takes time for the light to travel between it and you. In effect, you're seeing the distant object as it was in the past. James Webb will look at some of the most distant galaxies ever observed, seeing them as they were when the universe was very young. As well as being, frankly, really cool, it's helpful to look at very old galaxies, because they're different from the younger galaxies that are nearer to us. According to NASA, older galaxies tend to be smaller and clumpier than their younger counterparts. With stars being born in pockets of intense activity, over time, these small galaxies spread out and transformed into the type of galaxies we see more commonly today. Astronomers still aren't sure why exactly this happens. Using James Webb to observe these galaxies will hopefully help them fill in some of the blanks. There are many questions that remain about galaxy formation. For example, we know that at the center of almost every galaxy is an enormous black hole, hundreds of thousands or even a million times the mass of the Sun. These black holes are arguably more of a mystery than the galaxies that surround them. We don't know whether they form first or if galaxies somehow cause them to form after the fact. These are just a few of the topics James Webb will be studying. There's a full list of study topics for James Webb's first year available for the public to view, which includes questions about how planets form, searching exoplanets for signs of volcanic activity, examining the hot gas that exists between galaxies called the intergalactic medium, and even about the large-scale nature of the universe itself. Dr. John C. Mather, Senior Project Scientist for the Webb Mission and Senior Astrophysicist at NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center in Greenbelt, Maryland, said, "We are opening the infrared treasure chest, and surprises are guaranteed. How did the universe make galaxies, stars, black holes, and planets, and our own very special little Earth? I don't know yet, but we are getting closer every day." Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more SlashGear videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.